Okay. Please go ahead.
Hi, hello. Thank you all for being here. Let me share screen in full screen mode. Second. Okay, I think you can see now my presentation. So let me introduce myself. My name is George Papastefanatos. With Adonis Zervas, we're representing EOSC Enhanced project in this demonstration session. We are going to present you the functionality of EOSC portals that targets the providers, the service and resource providers. The talk is, the title is Enhancing Research Through Quality Resources, the EOSC Portal Experience for Providers. I work for University of Athens and Athena Research Center. Adonis is with JNP. For you who might not know, the EOSC Enhanced is a 2-year project which ends this November, and the main goal was to further develop and engage more users in the EOSC portal. And for this, we will mainly focus on the functionality for the service providers. So we will start with a short presentation about the functionality, and afterwards Adonis will provide a very short demo, a hands-on demo on this functionality on the portal. What you can do in the providers section of the EOSC portal? Mainly you can do three things as service providers. The first is to onboard resources like services and other types of resources. For the moment, we allow the onboarding of services in the EOSC marketplace, the catalog of the EOSC portal. This is a self-service process, which is interactive with the team, which is responsible for the onboarding. It is called EOSC portal onboarding team, and it is based on a workflow that I will explain later. The second for a service provider is the provider dashboard, which gives the a full control over the resources that are part of the EOSC marketplace. The users can actually see, view statistics and manage all the resource portfolio in the EOSC catalog for a specific provider. And finally, the application programming interfaces give the ability for programmatic management of resources from other systems in the EOSC catalog. And these are also available for the providers, the service providers in the EOSC catalog. So I will provide first an overview of the onboarding process for you who might not be aware of. The way for uploading and onboarding resources and services in the EOSC catalog is through the onboarding process, which has, the main onboarding process has three main steps. The first has to do with the authentication of a user who will represent the organization which acts as a provider. The user must log in with a credential provided by centrally by the EOSC portal through the EOSC AAI service. Then the user must provide information about the organization which acts as a provider. This is called the provider profile, the information collected for the organization. After that, the user must provide information about a resource, about the first service which will populate the catalog for this provider. And all the information collected for this resource is called resource profile. In essence, these two types of information are the provider profile and EOSC resource profile. These are, let's say, two standards that have been agreed, and we are now in version 3.0. These are evolving, but for the moment, the portal supports this version. The profiles, as I said before, collect and gather information in, let's say, building blocks. For the provider, we collect information for generic information about the organization name, the URL, about marketing information or classification information about this organization, the location, contact details, maturity or other information. And for the resources that are uploaded, are registered in the catalog, we collect information, again, generic information about the title of the resource, URL, if it is online, classification about, for instance, the scientific domain or the type of the resource, the availability, the geographical language availability, contact information and dependencies from other services or from other platforms, attribution and funding source information, and also information about the type of access, if the ordering information, how a user can order, and financial information. All of this information, we can split information into mandatory fields and into optional fields. The mandatory should be filled during onboarding for the onboarding to be complete, for the form to be complete. So we have some minimum set of fields for the provider and the resource that should be filled in order for users to proceed. Also, regarding the profiles, there are some values that are free text, and you can fill in a free text form information about the provider and the resource. But also we have fields that are, let's say, take values from a control vocabulary for a fixed list of values. You can see here some examples about the provider and the resource. And these, let's say, values are part of controlled vocabularies that are evolved along with the profiles. So this is, let's say, the an overview about the onboarding process and the information you must provide in these forms. Regarding the provider dashboard, a provider, as we said before, has, let's say, a full control of the information that is provided in the EOSC catalog. This is visible through a dashboard where the user can see all the provider he or she is responsible of and the resources that are part of each provider. And in this dashboard, users of a provider, representing a provider, can manage the resource portfolio. They can filter and update information, and also they can view usage engagement for the resources they provide. The actions and all the information is available through a panel, and they can view this information and statistics as for all the provider resources, but also for individual resource. And also they can view the list of resources that are public or draft, public in the catalog. They can activate or deactivate a resource from the catalog. They can update the information of the provider or the information of the resources. And of course, they can add new resources. A screenshot of this dashboard is visible. You can see here there are different charts that offer information about the usage. And this information is collected from the interaction of users with the resources offered by specific providers. Also, there are different views for all the actions that are logged, all the actions performed on a resource, not only by the provider users when a user updates the information, but also from the EPOT members. All these actions are logged and are presented in a timeline, which is available in the form of history for the users. I will go into the overview of the EOSC Portal APIs, the third, let's say, functionality which is offered to the providers. The APIs offer functionality for provider users to update information in the catalog. For instance, aggregators, thematic and regional catalogs, resource providers, They can programmatically manage all this information which is available in the marketplace, but also offer functionality to consumers, to resource catalog consumers who would like to build added value services on top of this information to retrieve information from the APIs. How to use the open the portal APIs? In brief, there are three steps. First of all, a user who would like to be a representative of provider must, in order to start using, must onboard the provider organization into the EOSC portal. The provider must be an active provider in the EOSC portal. Then this user can actually use the credentials provided by the EOSC AAI and obtain an API token, which is, let's say, the way that APIs authenticate every method, every call in the API method. So this API token is used for authentication. And use this API and all the methods that are available to create, update, or let's say manage content in the EOSC portal, mainly the provider profiles and the provider information and the research information. In order to obtain an API token, the user must be logged in, must have the credentials of, let's say, provider administrator, and go to the a page that is for issuing an API. This API is valid for 8 hours, but there is a mechanism for refreshing this API. I will not go into technical details in this presentation. There is documentation in the EOSC portal for that. And this token can be used for all information that alter the content of the catalog, but is not necessary for information that retrieves the public information that is already available, I mean, publicly in the marketplace. The APIs use SSL. There is a base URL, you can see here, api.eosportal.eu, that is the base URL for all API calls. And after this, you can use the name of the method. For instance, this method that is resource slash all retrieves all the contents, all the resources that are the public information of the resources that are in the catalog. The organization of the API methods are according to the profiles. We have the provider controller that offers methods for altering and retrieving information for the provider. We have the resource controller for the information for the resources. There are get, post, and put methods that retrieve, create, and update information in the EOSC portal. There is documentation based on the open API standards that you can use and see all the necessary formats, all the formats we expect information in JSON format in order to update and use the API. For the provider components, there are different deployments. The production is you can see providers.eosportal/openapi, but also there are sandbox. There is a sandbox environment. It is, let's say, a stable replica of the production where you can use as a playground for the APIs and the end user. You can start onboarding everything. You can use as a playground. Changes do not update the public catalog. And there is also the beta environment, which offers beta features, early releases, and also changes do not update the public catalog. I will conclude this introduction with the portal tutorials and communication channels. You can find a variety of tutorial and material that can help you start using the portal as a provider user. You can see, you can find webinars, you can find presentations and everything that explains in details how to use the portal. And also there are different channels that you can use for stakeholders engagement. The entry point is the eosportal.eu, but also there is a dedicated mailing list onboarding at eosportal.eu that goes to the onboarding team. You can schedule a webinar, you can contact the onboarding team. And you can see here other URLs. And finally, there is a feedback button in every page of the EOSC portal, not only in the providers, but also in the marketplace, where you can provide your feedback. This creates a ticket that will go to the onboarding team or to the technical teams. You can use the help desk link, and of course, you can review the privacy policy summary. I will stop here, and I will give the floor to my colleague, Adonis Zervas, who can share his screen in order to proceed with the demo.
Thank you, George. Thank you very much for the introduction. Let me start by sharing my screen. Okay. Can you confirm that you can see my screen? Hope so.
Yes.
Thank you, George. So for this demonstration purposes, I will be walking you through the portal and the registration process, which is consists of three basic steps. The first step is for you to authenticate yourself as a provider and the representative of the provider. The second step is for you to register your organization, your resource provider. And then the final step is for you to register the first and the rest of your services. The first step is after you visit the eosportal.eu port site to press the login button that you see on the top right of your screen. By clicking on this button, you are navigated to, let me, because it keeps the cookies and I need to somehow. After you press the login button, you are navigated to this screen through which you can use any academic authentication and authorization infrastructure or social account mechanism to log in, to authenticate yourself. By using either Google or academic accounts such as Daria or Cido OpenAir. Additionally, you can navigate through this search menu to locate your organization infrastructure to use your credentials in order to log in. For the demonstration purposes, I will be using my Google account. Let me log in. So you see that you are navigated to the portal. As you can see now, I have already logged in, and because you see the logout button in the top right of your screen. So the next step is for me to click on the apply button, and you see that we request from you to assert that you are the authorized representative of the resource provider that you are registering, and that you agree with our privacy policies. For this purpose, I have already pre-filled this template. This is the profile resource. This is the resource provider profile, which contains all the information of the resource provider. You see that we have organized this information in 8 information blocks. It consists of different attributes and the control values that each that we can use for instance to fill in. Above this box, we provide you with some suggestions or some descriptions in order for you to assist you in what kind of information we request from you to fill in. The asterisk indicates that this attribute is mandatory and needs to be filled in. Again, what you need is to go through all the information blocks and fill in all the information. Sorry, I cannot see the submit button for some reason. Okay, yes, thank you. As you can see in the top right of your screen, you can also download this application either through the Excel or a PDF and at your own convenience to continue with the upload and upload all this information afterwards in the portal. Upon completion, what you need to do is to click on the submit button in order for you to complete the registration of the provider profile. As Yorgos mentioned in his presentation, you see that we have installed this ribbon in the left, in the right middle of your screen, where through which you can provide your feedback regarding regarding your user experience or your user interface, or provide some feedback on overall. After you submit, click on the submit button. Our team, the EOSC Portal onboarding team, will be notified, and you will get an email with some recommendation suggestions after we review your application. Upon approval, you will have to revisit your dashboard through my provider's menu. You will see this screen, and from the more options menu, you can either visit your other resources, or if this is the first time you register your first resource, you can click on this button in order to gain access to the resource profile template. This, similarly to the provider profile template, you need to is requested from you to fill in the attributes. Again, at least you have to fill the mandatory fields, which are noted with this asterisk. And for this demonstration, I have already pre-filled those. As you can see from my dashboard, by clicking on the title of the on my provider, I gain access to my dashboard, and I can see the statistics that Yorgos mentioned. I can move and see information regarding the history, the infos, all the resources that I have already registered under this provider, some draft resources which I haven't completed so far, but I'm planning to complete in a later stage, some messages, or add new resource. Again, I can update the provider information, or I can even delete the provider or use the API to onboard a significant number of resources. Now, by clicking the title of the resource and clicking the update resource button, I gain access to the profile of the resource. All those informations describe this resource, and those that are noted with us are mandatory and are mandatory for you in order to complete the submission and the registration. By clicking the submit button of the resource profile, I will be redirected to my dashboard. And I, of course, I can. The EPO team will be notified again. At this stage, the EPO team will review again your application. And upon successful completion, you will be welcome to revisit your dashboard and continue with registering the rest of your resources. It is important for now to mention that only the first resource is being reviewed, and so that to familiarize you with this process and to make sure that you understand the quality of the records that you need to provide in this registration, and from there you can continue with the registering the rest of the resources, either through API or through your dashboard. I hope that I have, this is from my end, Yorgos. I don't know if you want to comment on this or you want to add something. We show you have all the tools through which you can provide us with your feedback, the email, the ribbon, and please mind that this is a really straightforward process. All you have to do and to conclude with this is to authenticate yourself, registering your provider, and then don't forget to revisit the portal and register the first and the rest of your services.
No, thank you, Adonis. I think it was a very nice overview, a demo. And I will ask for themselves, I mean, test themselves, especially in the sandbox, to familiarize with the onboarding process. There are more, I don't remember, 300 resources onboarded so far. So it's not, it's a system that is already tested. And I think there is a small overhead for, let's say, modeling the offerings and the resources according to these profiles. But next, the process is quite intuitive. So we have, let's say, a couple of minutes before this session ends. So I don't know if any of the participants of the audience would like to ask or comment or provide any kind of feedback on what is already up and running in the EOSC portal for the providers. If not, I understand it, you know, these sessions are in parallel. So I guess the competition is quite big. Although I think we have, let's say, different channels to for you to provide your feedback, and you are more than welcome to do so, and also provide, you know, provide feedback regarding new changes or new requirements that you would like to have in the EOSC portal, a special functionality for the providers. So I don't know if there is no other feedback, and I will then ask to conclude this session and this demo. And I would like to thank you all for being here, and especially and also in OS Fair. And tomorrow, I think we will have also the chance to repeat this demo at 6 p.m., 6 o'clock.
Thanks, everybody. I'm stopping the recording then.